Welcome to Seat Time, everybody. Brian Pierce here. We're doing another interview with Cody Webb, the blonde-haired, white-teeth dude that races dirt bikes and did a phenomenal job at the X Games this couple weeks ago in the Enduro X. Got silver medal, which we're going to be able to take a look at over the internet in a little bit here. But Cody, how is your evening going this evening?
So far, so good. Just been, hanging out, working on my track, trying to get everything dialed in, and hanging out.
After doing the X Games, you say you're working on your track. Is there anything specifically that you're doing to it that you might have learned there track-wise, or you're just making some changes to change it up?
I'm making a little bit of changes just to make it a little more similar to what we'll see in the courses. And X Games, the wood pile was absolutely nasty, so we toughened mine up a little bit, and I think did a good job of that.
All right. We did actually talk a little bit with Corey about the wood pile. He mentioned how nasty it was and that y'all had discussed that fact. Please give me your kind of take on why that was so nasty.
Usually in Endurocross, we come out of the water hole and they got like a lot of sand, and usually that soaks up most of the water that we drag on the course. But at X Games, it was like 10 feet of sand and it wasn't even deep. And then you go straight into the wood pile and, everyone riding all night was just dragging water in there, and like you can feel committed and try and commit through the logs, and no matter what, your feet were sliding off, bike was going one way, your body's going the other. It was a struggle to get through every lap, and fortunately for me, I stayed strong through there and paid off.
It did pay off. A silver medal at the X Games. I mean, what is that for you? Just take us through the emotions or whatever it was that you felt, when you came through with that silver medal.
Yeah, as soon as I came across the line, and I knew I had just enough room to like kind of take it easy around the last turn, not spin out, and it was unbelievable. I was so stoked, and I came and congratulated Brown. He's been right there at the top forever, and he put the hammer down, but I still felt super happy to get my first second place and get it at X Games with such huge exposure, so many people watching on the TV, and it was an amazing experience and something that I'll never forget, that's for sure.
I don't think that there's a way how, unless obviously you go back maybe and get gold, but then at the same time, if you get gold, you're always going to remember the fact that, it's like, well, I got silver, then I got gold. It's kind of a big buildup. Is there any other like craziness that sticks out in your mind from the X Games? Maybe not just about the racing, but just the atmosphere in itself. Obviously, a guy like myself, I've never been there, so I don't really know how it goes down.
It's pretty killer, we just show up and we go get our credentials, and then basically once you get your pass and your little wristband, you can go wherever you want, whenever you want, all around the whole Staples Center, everything. But it's funny for us because no one has any idea who we are. Like, people only recognize people on MTV, so I feel so official, but then at the same time, no one really cares or gives a damn. But it kind of puts us in the spotlight. I felt like I was in the spotlight. Get to hang out in the athlete's lounge, all this free stuff. Get to take home a bunch of iPhone swag. I don't even have an iPhone, which sucks, so now I need to buy one. But it's a cool experience, and last year was fun, but I didn't really get to experience that because I kind of showed up last second. And this year I showed up early on purpose to watch some of the other events and basically take it all in.
Man, well, one, I have an iPhone. So if there's any need, you just go ahead and put that in the mail. I'll take it. We'll write your number on it. That's fine. I'll totally take that. So Mike Brown totally ditched his bike, and I saw you kind of like, I was watching the final video again today. I watched you kind of like, you teeter-totted yours on there. You run over, try to high-five him and stuff like that. Did you have any inkling that you wanted to maybe haylay your bike and kamikaze it into Mike Brown's? Would that have been fun?
That would have been killer, but, if you win, I think you have that right to launch your bike. And I didn't win, and I don't know what was going on in my mind. I just wanted to, get off my bike and just praise the Lord, bow down on my knee, do the Tim Tebow to the ground, something like that.
I like
but,
it.
It was just, I don't know. If I look back at it, I definitely would have done a bike launch, maybe a backflip off the log. Who knows?
Well, I think in that situation, you're absolutely, allowed to do anything you want to do. I mean, you're pretty much, you just did a phenomenal, phenomenal job. The racing that has to go on, I mean, if you look, at Tadej Bozuziak, you were talking about the wood pit. I mean, you look at any of the footage, they slow-mo it, and you just see his front tire just whoop, right out from underneath him, and that pretty much ended his race. From there, he was playing catch-up. So you know, if somebody like that that they praise is the best endurocross rider, obviously it can go either way. And so congratulations on staying upright, racing a great race, and then getting the silver medal. You know, what does it take now to go back and get the gold?
Basically, I'm just going to have to hit the tire jump as hard as I can, like Mike Brown was, and air it like 15 feet in the air.
Yes, you are.
And I just got to up my intensity. My start could have been a lot better. I had a really good start in my heat race from kind of on the outside. And I was just a little slow, but I played it smart around the first two corners and just kind of used my size and shoved my way in there and came out in like fourth or something in the first straightaway. So, I can get a better start, a little more intensity. And, you know, Mike Brown got an amazing start and just put the hammer down and put a gap on us right off the bat, and the rest of us were kind of battling, fighting with each other, and he was riding his own race, and that's what you got to do, mistake free.
All right, mistake free, that's what it's going to take to get gold medal. I like it. I do have the one weird question about the start ramp, and did you ever think about Hell Track from the movie Rad when you looked at that thing?
No, I didn't, but like that's pretty much the great representation.
Because I really think that they should not just have you start up there. They should have you come around like they do in Rad every time and go back down it. So that way, Crew Drones and Brad, you know, you guys can fight at the end. I think that would be a much more epic way to end it. You know, we could have lots
of... It'd kind
of
be like Supermoto Endurocross, too. You just get to shoot up the wood board, power slide on the flat, and launch back down halfway.
Yeah, the super, super slippery plywood.
Yeah, if the track already wasn't slippery enough, you know, it was just like a struggle to get around and not wash my front end out in every turn, and then let alone race it, and then have to go up the slippery plywood.
Well, I'm not racing it. I just want to make it more entertaining for me, and hopefully that you guys, you know, have more fun.
It would probably be pretty fun.
It'd be interesting. All right, we also know that you just got back from Mexico. What were you doing down in the, you know, in the southern regions?
I was hanging out with a bunch of freestyle guys, another trials rider, and I was a fill-in alternate on the Nuclear Cowboys show. So I came down there and had one day to learn how to do all this choreography that these guys practice for like a week straight. So I basically got to hang out in Mexico, cruise by the, you know, hang out by the pool, try and get my tan. That didn't work, even though I'm from California.
I was about to say, where are those guns, man? Come on.
No, they're not there. But
I understand. I'm right there with you.
But, you know, I just got to, you know, it was a good time and met a bunch of new people and had a good time putting a show on for all the crazy Mexican fans down there in Monterey.
Oh, man. Okay, my dad has actually watched some behind-the-scenes deal on some of those crazy shows, and that the choreography and, like, everything that those guys have to learn and how precise, you know, you have to be timing-wise is actually fairly difficult, and it's really hard to get down. How was that? I mean, obviously you said you had a day, but...
Yeah.
I mean, is that true that that's very, very, I mean, you just very focused trying to figure that stuff out?
Yeah, it was super tricky. I made like a bunch of different, like drew out maps of where I had to go. And right before the first show, like I was going everything in my head and I couldn't even remember what I had to do. But, you know, when you hop on the bike, all of a sudden stuff started making sense and I was picking it together. And luckily, my mind kind of remembered automatically and I went where I needed to go at the right time. And There's like dancers and fire going on, all this stuff. So luckily, I kind of just had to kind of like chase the dancers around, and that kind of gives me a good idea where I got to go next.
That probably wasn't the worst time either, chasing them around. I imagine that they're fairly attractive.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so it's not the worst to look at. Oh man, so were you like a ballet dancer when you were young? Is that why you're really good at this choreography? It just kind of stuck to it.
No,
absolutely not.
No,
that's okay. All right, so no crazy stories though in Mexico. Nothing that you made it to Tijuana and didn't make it home, and
no, it
nothing
was
that we nothing that we could talk about on the internet.
I'm trying to think about it, but I can't. I almost got some food poisoning down there, but luckily it passed over. And Matt Biden was up all night one night, I guess, just sitting on his throne, dying,
having a good time, I guess.
But it was pretty laid back and chill and. They didn't. We had like security, so we weren't allowed to really leave the hotel at night, and probably, that was probably a good thing. So we're all alive.
Good. All right. I want to see the silver medal. Do you have it?
Yeah. I got it right here. It's a little baggy.
Is it? It's like Flava Flav style.
Not quite. It's like a little bit of Aztec going on, you know, 2012.
Ah, end of the year or end of the world.
Yeah.
End of the year. Yep, definitely. It's going to happen.
End of the year. Well, yeah, we'll be the end of the year, definitely. It might be the end of the world. I don't know yet.
Yeah, we'll have to pay attention sometime in December. Well, that's cool, man. Congratulations on that. So what's next? You know, I know that it looks like you've kind of switched gears. I mean, so that's a change. You know, how's the beta? You know, what is quick forecast for you coming up forward?
Well, the trial stuff's all done with, right? You know, right before X Games, and just started getting ready for Endurocross. X Games, did that, finished well, super stoked, and now we're took like a little break right there in Mexico and started to get back into training stuff this week, and basically got to put the hammer down pretty soon, and the racing starts up again in September in Ontario, but I'll be going to Montana the end of August and Tennessee for that extreme knockout race.
The knockout,
so, yeah, I'll be hitting the big sky and the knockout with my teammate Max Gersten, and be gone for 2 weeks on the road. And then as soon as we're done with that, it's back to Endurocross. And I think in a couple weeks, there's a race I rode last year in Idaho. And I'm going to be barging up there and hopefully make a little bit of money and get some practice in for the series. And it's all about just putting time on the bike and making sure I'm in shape to try and push for 10 laps and at a high level, you know?
At a very high level, at a first place level, right?
Yeah, first place level. No more of this silver medal stuff.
Yeah, that's for the noobs, man. It's for the grums. All right, dude. Well, we really appreciate you taking out the time. We'd like to say again that this is sponsored by Fly Racing. You can check out their new 2013 gear at their website, flyracing.com. As well, this is Seat Time. Seattime.co is the website where you can find us. We're on Facebook, facebook.com/SeatTime, and Twitter, twitter.com/SeatTime, if you want to tweet us on the internet. Those are all the fun places to find us. Thank you very much, Cody. Have a good night, sir. And you were the first person that we've ever talked to twice as an interview, so I just want to say thank you, because you're interesting, you're handsome, and you're a hell of a good time. So we thank you for being a good sport.
I feel damn privileged right now.
Yeah, you should. Yeah, I don't talk to just anybody on the internet.
Yeah.
I talk to everybody on the internet. I have no filter. All right, man. We appreciate it. Have a good night, and we'll talk to you again soon.
Awesome.
Peace.
Later.
All right, dude.